Hi, Michael Anderson with Specialty Archery. In today's video, we're going to go over the features and benefits of our Pro Draw, which is a drawboard attachment that fits onto our Pro Press. The components of it include a gearbox, lower mounting bracket, upper mounting bracket, vertical support tube, horizontal support tube, optional bow scale. On the vertical tube, there's also a scale for measuring draw length, plotting draw force curves, things like that. We'll review that later in the video. Important to note is that the Pro Draw will mount to any bow press that has a 2¼-inch diameter jack stand. Here we have a bow already mounted to the Pro Press. So to operate the Pro Draw, we're just going to change the handle from the jack, move it over to the gearbox of the Pro Draw, and lower it so we can hook it on the loop. Now, one important point to consider when you're mounting your bow is you want to make sure that your limb stops are on the outside of the bow to allow for easy inspection when you're checking timing. If they're on the other side of the bow, it'll still be accomplished, but it's just harder to see. So you got the bow mounted, stops are on the outside, and hooked to the D-loop. One important thing to notice too is that this vertical member does swivel for different positions of different axes or different knock locations. And we just draw the bow by cranking the handle. An important safety point to consider when operating the Pro Draw is to be sure to keep your hands and body parts out of the string travel path when the bow is drawn. See the shaded area in red on this picture. Another safety precaution is to create a safety loop by tying approximately 6 to 8 inches of string loop material into a closed loop. This loop is then placed over the D-loop hook, around the bowstring, and back onto the D-loop hook prior to drawing the bow. This safety loop then prevents the bowstring from traveling forward in the event of D-loop breakage. When you get close to full draw, you're going to want to watch closely. Because of the mechanical advantage of the handle, you can damage the bow if you overdraw it. So you're going to want to watch here closely to make sure that you don't draw that past the stops. So one nice thing about the Pro Draw is that you can let go of the handle any point in the draw cycle, and it will not travel. It will stay exactly where it's set. There's a couple nice points to this. It allows you to plot draw force curves with a lot of different data points. And for cam timing, like with a lot of draw boards that have clicks, there are no clicks here, so you can position that cam very precisely to check for cam synchronization. One of the nicest features about the Pro Draw is that it will allow us to time or synchronize a bow's cams without removing it from the press. Here we've already drawn the bow, checked the timing. We have to make an adjustment. We're going to place the handle back on the press and bring this up to where it's very close, but not actually pressing the bow. You never want to press a bow past its full draw position. Here we're just simply using it as stops to allow us to relax the bowstring, remove the cams, or remove the string from the cams, check the timing and replace it. So here we've got these limb ears very close, but not touching. Place this on the gearbox of the Pro Draw and let the tension off. We'll see when we get to a certain point, the string and cables are going to become slack right here, which then allows us to add a twist, take a twist off, whatever we need to do to time this cam, to recheck it. Before we go back up, we should point out that you want to double check, make sure the string and cables are both routed correctly and haven't come out of any of the tracks. Make sure that's fully in the track. Okay. If you do draw the bow with the string or cables out of the track, you're certainly going to damage the string and probably damage the cam as well. So everything is in the track. Going to redraw the bow and check the timing once again. Okay, once we have timed our bow, synchronization is complete. We're going to place the handle back onto the bow press. You can either drop it down out of the way, like so, to remove the bow, or you can go ahead and pull the pins from the angle rods to get them completely out of the way. And the last step is to bring the bow back off the pro draw. Once we have that completed, we can remove the bow from the press. And now the bow has been properly timed. One really neat feature of the pro draw is that it will allow us to match two bows' draw lengths precisely. To do that, first thing we're going to do is drop this down, hook this in the D-loop, and we're going to want to remove the slack from the string but not actually put tension on the string, so set that at zero. And what we do once that's set at zero to determine a starting point for our O-ring is this bow has a 7-inch brace height. ATA standards are the brace height plus 1.75 inches to determine draw length. Well, this is 7, 1.75. We know we need to set the O-ring up here on 8.75 inches. These are graduated in quarter-inch increments, so it allows for quite precise draw length settings. On 8.75 there, that's slack's removed. And you start drawing the bow. And it'll be difficult to see, but this O-ring is actually going to go behind the jack stand here. You also want to make sure you keep an eye on your string stop where you don't overdraw and damage the bow. You'll be touching about right there. And it's difficult to see, but behind here you can see the O-ring is stopped on right on 28 inches. So if you needed to match the draw length of another bow, that would be your starting point, or that would be where you need to set it up to make sure this bow's draw length matches the other bow. Take it back off, we lower the bow, back down to the brace position. Another neat feature of the Pro Draw is that it will allow us to plot a draw force curve that's very precise because there's quarter inch measurements on the vertical setting, and we have a digital scale that reads to the 0.2 pounds. So we can plot this every quarter of an inch if we want to. We can go every half inch or every full inch to plot a draw force curve. Just like we did with measuring the draw length, we set it at 7 inches plus 1.75, so we start out at 8.75 inches. And as we see here, as we start drawing the bow, the poundage will start going up as our draw length indicator starts traveling down the vertical support. So it depends upon how precise you want to be. You can measure your draw force curve at every quarter inch, every half inch, or every inch. As the O-ring's traveling down, the poundage is going up. And how you'd plot a draw force curve is you would measure it at zero, and you would go 1 inch or 1/2 inch, however you want to go, measure the poundage, go to the next increment, measure the poundage, and so on until the bow is at full draw. Again, you want to be careful not to overdraw the bow past where the stops are contacting the string. Once again, this was Michael Anderson with Specialty Archery going over the features and benefits of our new Pro Draw drawboard attachment for our Pro Press. If you have any questions, be sure to visit our website at www.speciallyarch.com. Thanks for watching.